GaN has made a big difference in power semiconductors. And one of the biggest companies involved with this is Navitas. So can you tell us, how did you guys get started with GaN?
Thanks, William. Yes, GaN is a great technology. It's gone through a troubled childhood. There are a few early versions, but then in 2014, Navitas was founded, and we were able to take GaN on silicon, the enhancement mode version, from research and development into real production. And in 2018, we were in mass production, and the first fast charger using GaN hit the market. Since then, we're now 10 years old as a company. We've shipped 120 million GaN units, and we're in 10 out of the top 10 mobile OEMs. So it's really a great case of new technology adoption.
Now, one of the challenges with GaN was just using the straight semiconductors was actually very difficult for designers. What did you do that made a big difference?
That's a good point. Yes, GaN is a great technology. It wants to run at high speed. That's high switching frequency. But in a basic transistor switch, there are three terminals. There's the drain, the source, and a thing called the gate, where you turn the semiconductor on and off. You conduct or you block or isolate. And that gate in GaN is very brittle. So if you put too much voltage on it, it will break. So that's the vulnerability if you have what's called a discrete transistor. You have a stray voltage coming in, blows the device. Mm-hmm. Navitas is unique in having monolithic, that's same chip integration. And so we have a GaN main power switch, a FET, F-E-T, and GaN driver, GaN regulator, GaN level shifter, GaN isolators, GaN 2000 volt ESD protection on a single chip. And we've created an incredibly robust powertrain component that's very easy to use. So it's high reliability, and it actually enhances the reliability of the system.
Now, we have a bunch of products that are sitting around here. They're actually much smaller and much more efficient. Could you tell us a little bit about some of those?
Sure, yes. The start with the efficiency. GaN has better electron velocity, better field strength than silicon. So in a conduction form, it doesn't get hot. Mm-hmm. It remains cool, which is high efficiency. In terms of the speed, the switching speed of GaN is much better than silicon. So when you're moving packets of energy through a power converter, it does it much more efficiently, much cooler. And when you're moving energy through a transformer, if you do it quickly, but use small packets of energy, your physical transformer can shrink and shrink and shrink. And that's the key. The switching speed of GaN material enables the passive components, transformers, EMI filters, capacitors, to shrink. So you can get three times as much power in the same size box as with silicon. And that translates as three times faster charging at a lower system cost as well. So it's a huge benefit.
Now, in addition to that integration, you also now have a half bridge solution. Can you talk about that?
Sure, yes. So once you put one switch and IC elements around it, you can put two. So we have a half bridge component, which really simplifies things for the designer, also enables that high speed with reliability. And that half bridge can be used in higher power laptop adapters. It's also a great building block for motor drive. So GaN for motor drive in home appliances, whether it's a hairdryer, washing machine, a compressor for a refrigerator, anything where you're turning wheels, GaN is a great solution.
In addition to that level of integration, there are other features that you've sort of wrapped around because you have that additional control that you're interfacing with the designer, and they don't necessarily have to take additional steps to provide those kind of features.
That's correct, yes. In a traditional power supply, you need to monitor the current so you don't blow the thing up. That's traditionally been done by allowing that current to pass through a discrete resistor, measure the voltage across it, and calculate Ohm's law, the current. But you're basically burning energy just to measure how much energy you're converting. So what we've done, because we have the IC, as you mentioned, we know how much power, how much current is going through our powertrain. Mm-hmm. So we can calculate the current. So we already know that information. So it's a lossless current sensing. And that's another way that we can add value to the customer system, improve the efficiency, reduce system cost, reduce the size, and have a very reliable system.
Well, excellent. Thanks for filling us in where GaN has been going and where it's going to head.
Thanks very much, William. A pleasure.